Hey guys, Cliff Gray here with True Hunts and Flat Tops Wilderness Guides. Today is another footwear video, and this is my favorite one, okay? So this is like October through early November rifle hunts, and the footwear you need in the mountains for those type of hunts. The reason I like it is because it's consistent. It's gonna be cold, and then you're gonna probably have some moisture, all right? That could be wet snow, or it could be snow that's settled on the ground, okay? But it's consistent in that regard. It's not the best conditions that you could ask for, but it's consistently those conditions, all right? So what you need for these type of hunts is you need a waterproof boot at a minimum, and then you need to have a good warm sock system, and then you need to have a gaiter. And then, oh, I forgot one more thing. Okay, we'll go over that. Can't forget my camp shoes. But anyways, so what I recommend is we're gonna start with the boot first, okay? I've got another video on how to pick mountaineering boots, but I do recommend a mountaineering boot for these October and early November rifle hunts because they're a boot that you can use on a lot of different hunts in your hunting career, and they're waterproof, okay? And then they're warmer than other types of boots, okay? But at this point in the season, you don't quite need like a pack boot or a really heavily insulated boot, okay? Particularly during a semi-active elk or deer hunt during rifle season, okay? So a nice mountaineering boot that's waterproof is gonna be your go-to boot, okay? But because of the moisture, if it's a backpack hunt, that's probably all you're gonna have as a boot is that, okay? Your mountaineering boot. If it's a pack-in, deer elk hunt, wall tent type of setup like we do at Flat Tops Wilderness Guides, pack in another boot, you know? And you can make it a comfortable one, like a Merrill Moab or this Idaho boot from Crispy, a breathable, comfortable boot that works. And so that's good to have a backup boot because then your other boot can stay back at camp and it can dry out for a day if you get moisture in it, okay? So, but back on this primary boot, just one thing I failed to mention is unlike you'll see in the sheep and goat footwear video I talk about, and then also I talk about it a little bit on how to choose mountaineering on the video that's about how to choose mountaineering boots, is I talk about the sole, okay? The sole stiffness. On these hunts, like these October, early November rifle hunts, usually you're already out of the timberline, really rugged terrain for the most part, so you can get away with a little bit less stiff soled boot, okay? And that's gonna end you up with a comfortable boot, more comfortable boot, okay? Bring a camp shoe. I don't care if it's a backpack hunt or a wall tent hunt or whatever, okay? When your feet get moist, you wanna be able to get your socks off around the fire, around the wood stove in the wall tent, and put your feet in a nice camp shoe. The best one is Crocs. I literally think they made Crocs just to be a hunting camp shoe. But in all seriousness, though, they're waterproof, they're durable, and you put your bare foot in there and there's ventilation around your feet so you can dry out those soaked feet, all right? So on the sock system, all right? For me personally, at this point, I'm not using a lightweight wool sock anymore. I've moved to a rag wool sock as my outer sock, and I'm still wearing a liner sock, okay? The advantage of a liner sock is they're lighter weight, so on a backpack hunt, I can bring more pairs of those, and I can be changing out my liner sock every other day into a nice, putting my feet into a clean, dry layer there without a lot of weight penalty, okay? And then the other advantage having a liner sock is that if there's a little bit of movement in my boot that might poke up and give me a hot spot, that the two sock layering system is going to mitigate that, okay? The rag wool socks are pretty darn warm, but for me, I run a little bit cold, and then I don't run a super highly insulated mountaineering boot, so I'm going to go with the rag wool sock. Some people are still going to go with like a darn tough mid-thickness merino sock, okay? And then the other thing, absolutely, without a doubt, bring a nice pair of gaiters, okay? Waterproof ones. These are the Yukon gator from Kuyu. I really like them. I personally prefer the Velcro gaiters. And then in these October and early November hunts, I want a gaiter that goes up the back of my calf. And there's a couple reasons why I like these. One, it keeps the snow off the top of my boot. Even if it's a waterproof boot, if there's snow up there, it's gonna end up getting into your boot. The other thing is that snow, you know, particularly mid-October, it can be kind of wet and it can get your layer, your pant layer wet, and that'll wick into your dry boot. So this high waterproof gaiter helps a lot, okay? The other thing about these Yukon gaiters is they're durable. I mean, these usually last me 20, 30 hunts at least. So basically, you know, a couple years of guiding, I can get through these and they hold up pretty good. And the other thing about them, for how waterproof they are, they're pretty darn quiet. So those are the reasons I chose those. There's some other ones out there. I'm sure you might find some other great models, but you might consider those metrics when you're looking. So that's your setup for those mid-October to early November rifle hunts.